There is another question that you could ask, and you notice I've changed the numbers on you a little bit. So in the previous one, I said I have light of wavelength 650 nanometers going through narrow slits separated by 0.25 millimeters. Okay? What if I reduce my slit separation a lot? Okay? So in this next question, I've reduced the slit separation by a factor of, it was 0.25 millimeters, right? So a factor of 100. So I'm now going to have a slit separation that's 2.5 microns. That's 2.5 times 10 to the negative 6 meters. And then you might ask how many bright fringes are visible. So what kind of question is that? What does that even mean? Okay? Once again, let's write down the equation for the fringes. We can dispense with the animation. You have d sine theta m is m times lambda. So sine theta m is m lambda over d. Okay, so the sine of the angle locating the fringe should be m lambda over d. Are there any restrictions on this value? Are there any restrictions on what the right-hand side of this equation could be equal to? Yes, it can't be larger than 1, because the sine of an angle is always less than 1, right? So remember m is an integer multiplier. Okay, so I should write down what lambda over d is for this case. Let me write down lambda over d. And I'm going to multiply that by an integer multiple. If in multiplying that by m, it exceeds 1, then I'm no longer going to see that fringe. So I get a sense of what's the maximum I can see before the angle exceeds 1. So let me write this number down. If I write 2650, lambda is 650 nanometers. That's 650 times 10 to the negative 9 meters. D is 2.5 microns. This is not millimeters. There's no units here. I don't know. That was a mistake. It's unitless because this is meters. And this is meters, and the meters will cancel. So that's just a number. It's m times 0.26. Okay, so it's m multiplying a fairly large number. So what is the largest, how many bright fringes am I going to see? Including the central bright fringe, how many bright fringes would I see? Anyone have an answer for me? For what value of m will that exceed 1? When m is 4, what is that equal to? If I were multiplying 0.25 by 4, right, I would get 1, right? So 0.26 times 4 is going to be larger than 1. So will I see 4? Will I see m equals 4? I will not. I will see the 0, m equals 1, 2, 3. Okay? So I will only see, I made a mistake. This is a different problem I was solving. Let's do that. So for m equals 4, I get sine theta m greater than 1, which is not possible. So need m less than 3. Less than or equal to 3. So basically what I'm going to see is m equals 0, 1, 2, 3. So I'm going to see, aside from the central bright fringe, I'm going to see 1 on top, 2, 3 on one side, 1, 2, 3 on the other side. I'll only see a limited number of bright fringes. Does that make sense to everybody? So you can see that as the slit separation gets comparable to the wavelength of the light, I'm not going to see interference patterns anymore. The last point I was making is that once the slit separation gets comparable to the wavelength, if d and lambda are equal, then I'm not going to see any fringes. Why? Because if d and lambda are equal, lambda over d is 1, sine theta is equal to m lambda over d, m can't be greater than 1. What does it mean to have one fringe? There's no interference. Okay? So if lambda and d are equal, I do not see an interference pattern. I must have a wavelength that's smaller than the slit separation in order to see interference fringes. So remember this when we get to diffraction as well.